I pressed it. Oh, looks like the green button isn't working. Well, nostalgia satisfied. Might as well scavenge the batteries. Huh? I hope it's not malfunctioning because the batteries are low. Now I got batteries. Better put those back in the walkie-talkie so you can warn Jude. It doesn't need batteries, it's more like, you try to think of a comparison to illustrate that this key isn't digital, but you can't find the right analog. Your precious heirloom doesn't run on batteries, though. It does seem to have a strange energy to it, doesn't it? Kind of like a delicate spiraling power, like a seashell warmed by the sun, or a snake coiling on a hot rock. You don't run on batteries, you run on Razzle Dazzle. Okay, so what I've been wondering now is, if everything reacts to batteries. Batteries? So gauche. Not like this painting, or ballet, or paintings of ballerinas, or ballerinas painting. Seriously? I just have to see what everything says. Hope you guys don't mind very much. It's entertaining, though. We're bound to find some interesting stuff. The situation already pretty charged, wouldn't you say? No need for batteries, bucko. This movie ran on the power of the imagination, and also on the power of ending the movie halfway through the story. There was one campfire spookum about a kid who secretly ate a robot, and the other kids figured it out because he ate batteries. It was... The world of Acorn's Shadow is pretty low-tech. A lot of magic, though. Can't do a quarter length without stepping right in something eldritch. Eldritch is spelled wrong. The fourth... There's only one T in eldritch. Something eldritch and befuddling, it seems like. It's really cool. Huh, they do sort of look like little energy tanks. Are energy tanks just batteries? Like everything on that show runs on magic. Don't start. What is this? Did I look at this? Oh yeah. Yeah, I don't think I tried stuff on this though. Yeah, I looked at it. Shika keeps a secret magical diary of all the dangers that the creatures of the forest faced, which, now that you think about it, strikes you as a little counterintuitive. Maybe she's just trying to stay in business. Snakes and the poisons they deliver via their fangs were a big problem on Magical Animal Companion Heal Rescue, but the ones on your heirloom have always seemed friendly and familiar. Kind of like they know the secrets, they're excited for you to soon find out. Okay. Wait, what? Where did that come from? Princess Shika doesn't need a dumb walkie-talkie to call her brother. She just whispers his name to the wind and he appears, and away they go. Oh, what's that? Oh, that's the wrong thing. There's a second line. It's the deer. The deer is her brother. Okay. I get it. Oh, Princess Shika could never be a tap dancer. Her feet end in deer hooves. She just couldn't get the right percussion going on with those velvety things. Huh. They do sort of look like energy tanks. Are energy tanks just batteries? An electric performance, as always, from the lovely Ginger Rogers. There are too many kinds of batteries, just like there are too many kinds of blocks in Block Hustle. You guess. You don't feel all that strongly about this, frankly. Bubsy really doesn't need any more energy. He's already a self-sufficient whirling dynamo of garbage and trash. Hooking up the poster to a power source still won't let you play Second Mom. Believe me, you've tried. No need, it's plugged into the wall, like most TVs. Oh, I didn't look at the TV. Oh. Oh, that's more than enough of that. Nope, no more of that tonight. Clink! It clinks right off the surface. This key was made to unlock your diary, not your TV. Your TV is not something that needs to be unlocked. You think you've got this concept down, but just in case, you're willing to repeat it to yourself should you forget and try to use the diary key on your TV again. This TV has power, but no antenna. The walkie has an antenna, but no batteries. Can they help each other? No, they can't. Their mutual needs and resources are only complementary on the surface level. Your precious heirloom from your beloved mother clinks roughly. It cut off. I didn't click anything. Against the screen, you clink it a few more times. Again. You don't know what's come over you. You stop. You could dance to your video games, and of course you have, but tap dancing tends to rattle the old console so much that it freezes on occasion. It's not a great tap dance accessory. Alright, batteries on this. You probably think of a handheld gaming device, which it plainly is not. These cartridges already have batteries in them, otherwise how could you save your game? Get real. Oh, I meant to hit that. Your window doesn't need electricity. How would that even work? It's a glass-filled hole in the side of the house. You decided to chalk this Looney Tunes nutso idea up to your current case of monster rattles. It doesn't need batteries. It runs on, beans, you guess? You don't think there's real beans in there. At least you hope not. That thing is really old. What about this dude? His batteries died a while ago, but you don't really want to replace them. All they made him do was vibrate for hours with no off switch. When you try to remove the batteries, he just vibrated so hard you couldn't even hold on to him. You just ran out of the room, and when you came back later, he'd worn himself out. That's hilarious. Yeah, I gotta try the batteries on everything. Your computer doesn't run on batteries. If it did, how would you turn it off? By taking them out? Because, of course, the only way to turn off a computer is to shut it down and then manually turn off the power strip it's plugged into once the screen says it is now safe to turn off your computer. Obviously. I guess Windows 98 had that? Or 95 and 98? I remember that. Nothing in the medkit requires batteries to operate. No electric bone saws or anything. It is, after all, a junior veterinarian's medkit. This is just your clothes closet. None of your clothes need batteries. It's not like you have a pair of LA lights in there or something. I remember those. Were they called LA lights? It was something like that. Puppy Surprise doesn't run on batteries. That would frankly be a little unsettling. None of those toys are battery-powered, except maybe the Snork. You're not sure, because you never put the batteries in. The Snork was a rare gift from your pa, though he was gone again by the time you found it, sitting on the kitchen table, next to a huge shotgun for Jude. Nice. A huge shotgun. No batteries needed. Just give it a good shake, and the sparkly, floaty stuff goes swirling around. It's amazing. It's not technically magic, but you don't really care about what things technically aren't. No batteries needed. It has a plug-in, although if it did require batteries, they definitely wouldn't have been included. That's just how it goes. That's just how it has always gone. Batteries in the bed? What do you think this is? Don't Wake Daddy, the Parker Brothers board game with a battery-powered daddy who must be avoided while sneaking into the kitchen for a midnight snack? Well, don't you have an attentive father or food in the kitchen, so it's obviously not that. That's like sad and funny at the same time. Batteries for books. Books don't need batteries. They run on the power of the imagination, which means your imagination has to work a triple shift to make a book anywhere near as fun as anything that does need batteries. There's a very cool picture for the month with all the best characters from your favorite Skynet games. They don't need batteries, though, just because they're from video games. They're not actually here. It's just a picture. posters don't need batteries. They're perfectly capable of inducing magical animal-based wonderment all on their own whimsical steam. No batteries required. It's just a toy. Okay. So, I wanna... Oh, what about batteries for Melissa Joan Hart over here? It is her, right, that I'm thinking of? Clarissa? Played by her, I'm thinking. Clarissa doesn't need batteries. She runs on girl power. What an icon. What a luminary. You're glad you have this poster because it's definitely going to be worth big bucks someday when the world recognizes Clarissa for the dynamo she is. Did I try it here? Oh, yeah. Absolutely not. No way out of the question. That's not safe for babies. Okay. The same thing. I want to read the diary now. I want to see if we can leave the room. I don't know if it's a fail state if we leave the room without doing anything. An electronic diary. The very idea. Now you've heard of quite literally everything. Nothing that will ever happen to you after this moment of astonishment in which you have floored yourself with this bonkers idea will perturb you in the slightest. You've crossed the event horizon of novelty. A diary is kind of like a walkie-talkie that lets you talk to the past of yourself. Or at least it lets past you talk to present you and make you very embarrassed that present you was ever past you. You try to move past this, you mean past us. Doesn't fit. It was worth a shot, you guess. Well, not really. Okay, all stuff here. Your mom's had such a classy old world charm, it's hard to imagine her even existing in the same world as things like batteries and the crude chirping devices that run on them. Chirp, chirp. Which, you guess, she doesn't anymore. Geez, you felt like that one like a kick in the stomach. I think I tried this. Yeah, I did. Pictures don't need batteries. Not even pictures of you and your beloved dog. Thank goodness. Otherwise you'd be burning through the double A's keeping this sweet pic running around the clock. You couldn't tap dance your diary open, although if you wanted, you might be able to tap dance it off the desk if you wanted to. You don't want to, though. You're going to go ahead and head that line of reasoning off at the pass. That's not the way to open your diary. It's just an idle thought. You need your diary key to open your diary. Period. Okay, finally, guys. You unlock and open your diary. Nice. Juicy secrets. Here you come. Except they're just your boring secrets, so you don't care. But I can to read it, can't I? You don't usually have much to record in here on account of the humdrum life you lead, but you think today will be a different story. Maybe you should take a moment to record a note now, just in case this is your last chance to set down your final words before your tragic demise at the hands of a horrible, snaky thing. Same, right? So what about this page? Okay, so can't turn pages, apparently. I'm gonna write. Maybe something from your past will shed some light on today's terror mysteries. Some little detail mentioned offhand and forgotten. The key kicking off a causal cascade of connections that terminates in a catastrophe of snake monsters. April 13th, 1994. Dear Diary, ho-hum, nothing much happened today. I tried to make some new friends at school to maybe expand our social circle beyond just me and Jude's friends all the time. Wait, is it weird to call my brother's friends my social circle? Ah, well, you know what I mean, Diary. I don't have any friends, so I can really call mine, so I'm trying to branch out. I guess it's better than calling them my web ring. The kids at school are jerks, though, and they call me a poser when I try to talk to them about games I like and stuff. Between you and me, I think a bunch of the kids at school might be... evil? Jeez, now I'm sounding all paranoid like my brother. They're just up to no good. I can feel it. Joey. June 12th, 1994. Dear Diary, I wonder if the... words... I came home to a drunk babysitter. Let me see if it matches up. Well, first day of summer vacation. I can't wait to get a break from all those clowns at school. Sometimes I think what I really need is a vacation from humanity. Joey. October 25th, 1994. Dear Diary, I can't believe I haven't recorded an entry since the beginning of last summer. Needless to say, I haven't been back to school for a while now. Next summer can't come soon enough. I came home to a drunk babysitter again today. Sure is some quality adult supervision we youngsters are getting around here. She means well enough, though. Haven't heard from Pa in weeks. Last we saw of him, he popped in the house to drop off more stupid mummies and globes or whatever, then skipped off to go on more adventures. What a bozo. Also, how lame is it that he made us call him Pa instead of Dad when we were growing up? I miss Mom. Joey. Frowny face. Is this going to be the last entry in your diary? Then by gum, you're going to scare the bejesus out of whoever finds it. Once you're a snake chow. November 11th, 1984. Dear Diary, forgive my hasty and nervous scribbling. I'm kind of scared, but maybe also a bit excited? Anyway, can't talk much now. There's a sly and cunning monster on the prowl. Possibly hungry for kid meat, too. So I've got to... Okay, I don't have a darn clue what I should do, but I'll fill you in later once I do it. Joey. Satisfied you've done your duty vis-a-vis posterity, in case the worst should happen, you relock your diary and hide the key again, safe and sound. You lock the key again? You've already done your duty to history by recording your potential last words. Time to shake a leg. Where'd I hide the key? Is it back in the puppy thing? I want the key. I gotta move over and go, yeah. Give me that. Oh, I can't take it. Your secrets are safe in the loving belly of a dog. Alright. Now, I know I have to put the thing in the walkie-talkie. Can I leave the room without doing that? You're not going out of there without a good reason, and you still need to warn your monster about that... your brother, about that snake monster. It could be heading right for him right now. Okay, let's put the batteries in the thing. Success! The walkie-talkie works like a charm now. A charm with battery power. You feel pretty pleased with yourself. It would seem you just solved your first puzzle of many on what is sure to be a sweeping adventure full of mysterious brainbusters. Technically, no, that's the second one. The first puzzle was the opening of diary, I think. Then again, putting batteries in a thing isn't technically solving a puzzle, you suppose. It's just overcoming a minor inconvenience that you created yourself using mundane, widely available modern technology. You don't care, though. You're counting it. I sure am. Okay, we've got a thingy. A message. Jude, you there? Are you alright? Yes. Been covertly signaling status and requesting yours. Over. You mean the lantern? I don't know Morse code. Would never use such easily decipherable code. Over. Well, then she really doesn't know it. Enemy agents everywhere. Over. Wait. Unover. Unover. Still unconfirmed vis-a-vis your condition following enemy serpent encounter. Over. Please report bite status. How many and how gross? Over. I'm fine. No bites, you weirdo, but thank you for asking. It was a close one. Great, was worried. Over. That reminds me, after I shut the door on it, I think I heard a clomping off back down the stairs. I don't think you should leave your treehouse anytime soon. It might be headed back your way. Well, it's been over an hour, so it's probably already there. No plans of leaving current location. Yard crawling with cryptid vanguard. Over. Cryptid Vanguard? Missing big picture, Joey. Over. Okay, maybe be a little less obtuse then? Purely defensive posture, tactically suicidal. Purely defensive posture, tactically suicidal. Monsters likely just distraction. Could have obscured additional agents on approach. Over. Do you mean like more monsters or... Can't discuss on unsecured channel. Can't be certain who's listening. Your evidence points to Antares Clan's conspiracy cascade, over. What? Over. Relieved you're taking this seriously. Are you totally prepared to begin forward operations? No going back now, Joey. Over. I was making fun of you, dweeb. I'm not going anywhere. Trust crucial on the battlefield, Joey. Hoping presence of monsters have tipped equation away from typical skepticism? Over. I trust you. Okay, that's fair. Okay, what do I need to know? Your current position not secure. Large yard facing windows. Location compromised to enemy. Situation rapidly deteriorating. Must abscond to attic, Joey. Over. The attic? Yes, the attic. Strong door. Well stocked with tactical material. Take left out of bedroom to go upstairs. Highest room in house. Over. I know what the attic is, Jude. It was just a weird suggestion. What else is new? More inscrutable rambling from my treehouse lunatic brother? Don't understand. You sounded confused. Trying to help. Over. Look, just shut up, okay? I'll sneak up there, lock the door, and you can... call the cops? Negative. Must assume local law enforcement compromised. You forgot to say over. Alright. 911 blocked our number after all your prank calls. Drills. Not pranks. Xenomorph incursion preparedness drills. Look. Failed miserably by Fat Cat Xenomorph collaborators of Haunt Switch PD. Jude. On our own. As a house, as a species. Over. Jude, I'm going to go to the stupid attic, okay? I'm sorry for being mean. Do you have your weapon? Over. What weapon? You mean my old weapon? What for? Serpents swarming everywhere. Over. You want me to fight them? With a flashlight? Don't blame you for being nervous with high concentration of serpent presence. Must be brave. Your brother believes in you and knows you can beat the serpents. Over. Stop seeing serpents. Do you recall where weapon is? Over. No! Clicking no here, which is invisible. Yeah? Yeah, it's in the closet. Okay, thank you. There's a flashlight in the... I didn't see that. Understood. All set then. Over. No, I mean the hall closet. Crap. Over. Hall closet. Okay. Yeah, well, I guess I'll have to take your word about this. You are sure about all this, right? Absolutely, extremely certain. Over. Over and out, squirt. Okay. We gotta go to the hall closet. So now it's in here. Okay. Yeah, we gotta go. Okay. There's nothing else to do. Good God. Looks like the coast is clear, for now. Alright. We have stuff. We have lots of stuff. I'm kind of, like, relieved that there's not a lot to actually... Wait, I have to click that. I can probably look at all these things, I'm sure. Better hurry over to that hall closet and retrieve your weapon before that crafty old serpent... You mean snake can get the drop on you. Alright. Hold on. The music seems louder. Over. So I should get my old weapon from the hall closet and then head up to the attic, right? Affirmative. Also refrain from excess chatter. Over. Alright, yeah. Bye. Could alert monsters. Over. Yeah, I got it. I'm going. Bye. Can't be too careful in espionage game, Joey. Silence golden. Over. Jude, shut up. Remember one time on training mission couldn't keep my trap shut? Hoo boy. Really landed us in a pickle. Over. You've never had any training. I'm turning off the walkie. Bye. Over and... Same. This game's so funny. Alright, so we got stuff. Do I have time to look at all this stuff, or will I get interrupted by a serpent? I mean, snake. The lightning something? Stormy? Was only a clever distraction, masking a secret abduction. Nope, his friends bought him a special surprise. Jude insisted the terrified horse was being abducted. Your counter-argument completely schooled him. This painting now commemorates your triumph and a particularly spectacular equine nativity. Jude insisted the terrified horse was being abducted. Oh, sorry. Nothing else to look at? It's your mother's jewelry box, a precious heirloom of immeasurable sentimental value. Also, there appear to be your brother's empty cans of Pringles. I bet you the key goes to that. This thing's always giving you the creeps, but that didn't stop you from patching it up after Jude accidentally ripped it with an experimental foamless dart. You're not even sure he wants out. Just look at him. Ugh, no, the chains would rattle and, geez, it'd be horrible. Okay, nothing there. It's a globe-like sculpture with an arrow that conveniently alerts you to the location of the ceiling. Ah, so that's where it is. Thank you, globe-like sculpture. Spin it. You give it a tap. Wow, look at it go. Well, that was stimulating. Equally mysterious. No, you take that back. What were you thinking? Your heirloom is at least 7 Babysitter's Club's mysteries more mysterious than the globe-like sculpture. That's a huge gulf, and a difference of degree is a difference of kind. You've always felt this to be true. A difference of degree is a difference of kind? Never heard that before. Your percussive footwork seems to set off its internal gyroscope or whatever. Maybe it's a tap dance detector? Your potential esteem for this relic rises slightly. Now, okay, I wasn't sure if it said to the right or left. Well, I'll finish looking at this area first. No, you might jostle your mom's jewelry box off the table. That's interesting. I never really took a good look at this sculpture. From the first and last dart gun war with Jude, Belinda here provides great cover for those who refuse to use firearms, namely you. You tried to distract him with your tap dancing and then stuck a dart on him. It didn't work. At all. She seems unimpressed. For such a beautiful work of art, she has lousy taste. She might topple over, and what crueler way to kill a ballerina than by tap dancing her to death? No, you'd never forgive yourself. We don't want to use guns. Equip. Nice. This gun can shoot a stream of water up to 50 feet away. Too bad you don't use guns. But we need that. We need to fill it with acid or something. No way. It might rust or tarnish or whatever bad thing happens to precious heirlooms when they get stupid gun water on them. Gun water. You try to tap it right off the couch, but it's nestled into that plump plush. Pretty good. Plump plush. You don't use guns. Damn it. I want to use the gun. More stuff. Same thing here. I can use it? How do I use it? You could scrounge some ammo, but you don't use guns, so you won't. Okay. Kessel Grayskull. Interesting. Looks like a giant hamster thing. This is the door to your neurotic dork of a brother's maximum security bedroom. He keeps it locked up tight because of all the silly conspiracy work he does in there. You sincerely doubt you'll be entering this room anytime soon, but really, why would you even want to? It's full of nerd stink and goober crud, not to mention it's where his pet usually lurks. His pet? You love all animals, but just the same, that's one you'd rather let Jude deal with. Okay. So we got Area 51, restricted area, keep out. No trespassing beyond this point. Photography is prohibited. Warning, radio frequency radiation hazard. To stop radiation, remove key from PA interlock. That's in Russian. No way, your mom left it to you, and Jude probably won't even care about it, because it has nothing to do with aliens. Percussive motion might set off Jude's pet, which is the last thing you feel like dealing with right now. Is it a snake? But it can come out of here though, right? He always keeps it locked. Even if you did manage to get in, he probably has traps set up. Not worth trying to get gum out of your hair again. Plus, there'd be his pet to deal with. No thanks. I'm really curious about what this pet is. Alright, we're done here then. What's this? Light bright? It is. You're light bright. Hours of fun with the number of hours and degree of fun dependent on the power of your imagination. Which, in your case, means many hours and a lot of fun. Very occasionally, your precious heirloom shines eerily in the dark, not unlike a light bright. You can't imagine exactly when this has happened, but you can picture it so clearly in your mind's eye that you're certain it's true. Your heavy, rapid tap stops would send those little pegs scattering across the floor, maybe even under your still-tapping feet. You might just slip and roll across them, down the hall, to the edge of the stairs, and tumble down them, breaking every single bone in your body. Every single bone. There's just no way you can take that risk. Light? Okay. Oh, how many different things do we have? That's like a cat, I guess? Me and brother and dog? Okay, spirally. A star. And kitty again. Oh, look at that. You've always been a bit creeped out by the monster in the water. It feels like the eye is following you, but only sometimes. Interesting. Alright. This lamp's not even plugged in, but there are at least 9 possible light sources in your immediate area, so maybe it got lost in a typically well-illuminated shuffle. You don't know. Those two don't share a visual motif. On the other hand, maybe that's what the lock dresser wants you to think. Okay, no. The key doesn't fit, which is a shame because you take back what you thought before. There's some aesthetic similarities, that's for sure. A little small for a stage, but that lamp might do for a spotlight, if it weren't kind of the opposite of a spotlight. Oh, that's freaky looking. Okay, what's this door? It's the hallway closet. If memory serves, there's a box full of some old belongings of yours in there. You wonder if it has what you're looking for. It probably does. It's not locked, at least you don't think it is. Maybe give the old doorknob a whirl before jamming your precious heirloom into the keyhole. I'm gonna look around the rest of the place first. Forceful, aggressive tap dancing is a good backup if this door refuses to budge, but maybe you could try opening it with your hands first. That's the edge here. What's down this way? Oh, we've been there. Hold on a second. So what's going this way, then? Downstairs? Jude recommended you grab your strife weapon from the hall closet and head up to the attic as quick as you can. You're sticking with that plan for now. What if I go like this? Oh, it just changes to that. Okay. So... is that the space for the attic? What's this way? Oh, literally, I just walk in circles. Oh. I can't head to the window. Oh, cool, her door. Sweet. Doesn't work. So what about in here?